video is going to teach you how to connect remote data sources to your grid. In order to make it easy to try out ZingGrid, we host a number of sample datasets on our CDN for demo purposes. You can, of course, easily modify the example to use your own remote dataset. For now, we'll be using the same dataset we've previously been using in the Getting Started series. Here we've defined the source attribute twice, but only one is needed. The top-level ZingGrid source attribute is for user convenience and gets propagated down to ZG data internally, so these two attributes are the same thing. We now have our first remote data source connected. One pain point of remote data sources is that you don't always have control over the data format returned. In our new dataset, we want to access company.employees. How do we display the employees in ZingGrid? If we try and access that dataset as is, we're not going to resolve the data in a useful manner. What we will get is a list of stringified objects. To resolve the data usefully, we have to use zgparams to tell ZingGrid what part of the object we want to use. In this case, we will use the recordPath zgparam to control what data is accessed on return. The name attribute will define the param used, and the value will be company.employees. This will access and display the employees array. This dot notation in string values is supported throughout the library for accessing objects. We now have the desired employee output we wanted. One thing to note is that the JavaScript tab remains empty, which solidifies just how simple it is to get started with ZingGrid.